Institute of NEET, Ahmedabad, India. Myself, Dr. Sushil Naik. Today we talk about sickle cell anemia. Sickle cell anemia is an autosomal inheritance. The genes located on the autosomes, and that's why it is called autosomal inherited disease. The gene responsible for the hemoglobin synthesis is HbA, which is generally dominant in condition. Its allelic gene is HbS. It is a defective gene. This is the gene and it is in recessive condition. If genetical constitution of individual is HbA, in this condition it is homozygous dominant condition and individual is normal. If gene is HbA and HbS, it means one is dominant and other one is a recessive. It condition is heterozygous, and in the heterozygous condition individual is a carrier of this disease. Students, what is carrier? The individual having diseased gene inside it can, or he or she can, inherit the disease in subsequent generation but do not show any symptom of the disease, and such individual is the carrier. If genetical constitution is HbS, it is homozygous recessive condition, and in the disease condition the hemoglobin formed is not proper. Sickle cell anemia is a qualitative disease, so quality of the hemoglobin vary over here. How? As we know, hemoglobin is a quaternary protein formed of four different polypeptide chains, in which two alpha chains are there and two beta chains are present in the constitution of hemoglobin. In the beta chain, at substitution of the beta chain, at the sixth position glutamic acid is present. Its genetic code is GAG on the mRNA. If the genetical abnormality occur at the time of DNA synthesis, during the DNA replication, the adenine kind of nitrogen base is replaced by the uracil. In this condition, genetic code becomes GUG, and this code for the valine kind of amino acid. So in this condition, due to genetical abnormality, glutamic acid is replaced by the valine at the sixth position. And that's why there is one amino acid is wrong in the beta chain. So this beta chain is wrongly synthesized, and this is not of the hemoglobin. In this condition, the entire hemoglobin molecule is wrong in the constitution. The quality of the hemoglobin varied, and that's why it is a qualitative disease. In this condition, hemoglobin cannot absorb or retain the oxygen in the RBC. The RBC change in its shape and they become sickle shape, and that's why this condition is called sickle cell anemia. This condition is generally found in the African people. Now it is found everywhere, but initially it originated in the Africa, and that's why in some people who suffer from the sickle cell anemia are always immune for the malarial disease, because malarial parasite Plasmodium need a proper RBC to complete its life cycle. But in this condition, RBC changed their shape, and that's why the Plasmodium could not complete its life cycle, and that's why they are immune to malaria. Sickle cell anemia is also considered as a case of codominance, as in the condition of the carrier individual, if we talk, HbA is a normal gene, HbS is a diseased gene. HbA produces hemoglobin which is normal, and that's why 50% hemoglobin in this carrier individual, which is heterozygous, having normal hemoglobin and 50% hemoglobin and ultimately RBC are defective. And that's why both the genes show their expression in the formation of hemoglobin. HbA produce a proper hemoglobin, HbS produce a defective hemoglobin, and that's why it is a codominance, as both genes express their activity.